Hello everyone. So this is what in yesterday's class we have learned. So let's see one more time. Those who have missed, you can just listen. So this is one application. So that in such a type of cases, how to find time period. So see here, this is a spring and this is a rectangular block which we have hanged. And the spring is having spring constant K, and this rectangular block is having length L, breadth B, and height H. Same like brick, we know brick. Same like that, you assume that one metal brick or any brick we have suspended, whose density is dB. Means this block material density is dB, and this block we have inserted into this liquid, and this liquid is having density dl. Okay, now initially when we have just dipped this block into the liquid, how many forces are acting on this? You just see kx plus fb, because this water will exert one buoyant force on this, that is in upward direction. That's why FB I have added here, and KX is restoring force, and just X is what? The displacement from its mean position. Whereas in downward direction, you are having weight, that is MG, and therefore KX plus FB is equal to MG. Upward forces is equal to downward forces at equilibrium. Okay. Now what we are doing, we want this block to be oscillate inside the liquid. That's why this block I am just pushing down into the liquid through a small distance y. Yes or not? Now I am just pulling and letting this block to oscillate. Initially x was there, plus again I am giving some y displacement. So spring force will be what here? K into x plus y, because of that extra displacement or extra pulling. And buoyant force, because this block is somehow inserted, so that is what buoyant force FB plus AY DLG, extra buoyant force, because some y distance or y length of this block is going to dip into the liquid. And that's why AY DLG. This is just phi rho G. This A into Y means volume, volume of that extra submerged part. DL is what? Density of liquid. And G is what? Acceleration due to gravity. This is what extra due to that Y dipping. MG is downward. Okay. Now net restoring force will be what? Minus KX plus Y, minus FB, minus AY DLG, everything this, plus MG. Okay, so if you will minus kx minus ky, just multiply with minus, minus fb minus ay dlg and mg. So already we know kx plus fb is equal to mg, hai na? So ye minus minus aur ye hai, to ye cancel ho jayega, because both are equal and opposite. Now left is what? Minus ky minus ay dlg. So just take y common from these two terms. You can see here, these two terms, from these two terms, I have taken y here outside, and just left minus also I have taken common, k plus a dlg y. Now this net force I can write like this also, minus k effective into y. And now this, from these two equations, this k effective is nothing but this value. So therefore k effective is equal to k plus a dlg, where dl is the density of liquid, a is area of cross section of that block. Okay. And G is what? Acceleration due to gravity. Now time period T is equal to what? 2 pi under root M by K effective. And therefore T is equal to 2 pi M by K plus ADLG. This is what? Time period of oscillation. Now if someone will ask you, find out the frequency of oscillation, what you will do? Just reciprocal of time period. And that's why frequency of oscillation is equal to 1 by 2 pi under root K plus A dl g by m. Understand? Please note down properly. Okay? right, no down. Okay, so let's move ahead. Now this is the next application. Already we have learned in the gravitation chapter, right? So you can see here, this is the earth. Okay, what is this? Earth. And what we did, there is a tunnel along the diameter. Okay, what is here? We have drilled tunnel along the diameter of the earth. And now what we did, at one end we have just dropped one mass m along the tunnel. Now let's assume that this mass is at depth d and it is oscillating, and this is the center of the earth. So from center of the earth to this mass, how much distance? R minus d, because this complete is radius of the earth. Assuming that earth has uniform density rho, how we are getting time period? Let's see. So body of mass m released at one end of the tunnel from here. So if displacement, we will see how much it is, r minus d. Okay, from the center we can see. Now gravity at depth, we know this formula, gd is equal to g into 1 minus d by r. So r minus d by r, just take LCM. So gd you are getting equal to g into r minus d by r. Already r minus d is y, so here I am substituting y. G y by r. Now force at this point is what? Minus m into gd. So minus m g y by r. Just gd value I am substituting here. That is g y by r. And we know force, f is equal to minus k y. That is what k effective we can say. K is equal to, after comparing these two equations, k is equal to mg by r. And therefore time period t is equal to 2 pi under root m by k. Substitute this k value. 2 pi under root m by mg by r. So mm cancel, this r will go up. And hence we are getting time period t is equal to 2 pi under root r by g, which is what time period of oscillation of that mass. And if you want frequency, just take reciprocal of this. That's why 1 by 2 pi under root g by r. Understand? Note down. Okay, so let's move ahead. And this is next application. Suppose now floating body with height h submerged in liquid. There is no spring. You can see this is a container in which I have taken water, and this is a block or any body whose mass is m. And you can see now this h is height which is submerged inside the liquid. Let rho be the density of this liquid and A is the cross-sectional area of this block. Here, weight of the body is equal to buoyancy, and therefore mg is equal to V rho g. V is volume. I am replacing with A into h, that is area of cross-section into height, which is submerged inside the liquid. And this gg I am cancelling, so I am getting m is equal to A h rho. Now what I am doing, I am just pressing this body little down. Okay, if a body is slightly pushed through a small distance y and released, what will happen? This will oscillate. So due to that push, what we are getting restoring force, F is equal to minus A rho g into y. Yes or not? Okay. And we know F is equal to minus ky. So k is equal to what? A rho g. Just use the formula for time period. T is equal to pi under root m by k. And k value is what? A rho g. Substitute here. Already we know from equation 1, m is equal to A h rho. Substitute here at the place of this m. Cancel this rho A. rho a, and just we are getting formula, that is t is equal to 2 pi under root h by g. If you want frequency, just take the reciprocal, and that is 1 by 2 pi under root g by h. This is what? One more application. Understood? Please note down. So let's move ahead. And now see, this is another application, that is YouTube. See here, I have drawn one YouTube, and inside this YouTube, there is a liquid, and whose height is h, filled from the bottom. Now, when we are giving oscillations, obviously this liquid will go up in this arm and this liquid will come down. So this will go on oscillating. Again, it will go up. Again, it will come down. So this will go on oscillating like this about the mean position. Mean position means initial position I have drawn with this pink line, you can see. So y is coming down, means this stress liquid is downwards. So here also the liquid will go up. In the next time, this may go up, this may come down. So this will go on oscillating. So here, if we will draw the free body diagram, this 2y, this is resultant force, and downward is weight. Because of these two, it will get oscillated. And F is equal to pressure into area. So pressure, you know, rho g h, but h is what here? 2y. So rho g 2y into area of cross section. And therefore, F is equal to minus 2a rho g into y. We know F is equal to minus ky. Equate these two equations. We will get k is equal to 2a rho g. And just substitute here. And m is nothing but what? Mass into volume, means density into volume. So this is just 2h and a. So you just substitute here this complete mass. And then you will get t is equal to 2 pi under root h by g. This m is equal to 2a h rho, why you got and how you got, you understood. I'm giving you here, try to understand. This m is the complete mass of the liquid. So this side h and this side h. So complete is 2h. So m is equal to rho into phi, we can say. So rho into phi, v means volume. Volume means area into 2h, understand? And that's why you are getting m is equal to 2a h rho or rho a 2h. Anything is same. Understood? Like this, you are getting m. And that's why 2a h rho by 2a rho g. Just everything you cancel, you will get time period. If you want frequency, just take the reciprocal. Understood this application? Clear? Okay. Note down. So let's move ahead. See here. Now, this bob oscillating in a bowl. So you can see here, this is a bowl and its center is O. This is a bob whose mass is M, we can say, and the radius is small r. Now, as this bob is oscillating like this inside the bob, inside the bowl, so I'm taking one position and resolving the component. This is mg cos theta, mg and mg sin theta. So this mg sin theta is nothing but restoring force. Because of this, it will oscillate about its mean position like this. Okay. Now f is equal to minus mg sin theta. If theta is very, very small, then sin theta is nearly equal to theta. And in this triangle, you see OPQ, sin theta is equal to y by r minus r. So just substitute sin theta value here, which is equal to theta minus mg y by r minus r. Then k is equal to what? Mg by r minus r. Substitute in the time period formula. T is equal to pi under root m by k. And you are getting t is equal to 2 pi r minus r by g. Understood? Okay. Note down. So next note point. See here. This is a piston. Can you see this? And this piston is having mass m. And inside this cylinder, we have filled gas under pressure P. And let the A is the area of cross-section of this piston. Okay. So this is A. And this is H. So when this is oscillating, then its time period T is equal to 2 pi under root M H by A into P. Okay. The P is what? Pressure inside. M is mass of the piston. H is how much displacement. about which it is oscillating, and A is area of cross section. Next one is elastic wire. Means now see, this is a wire whose Young's modulus is A and area of cross section is A. Young's modulus is Y and area of cross section is A and length is L. Now this block whose mass is M, we have hanged here, and because of which it is elongating through distance, let us suppose delta L. And delta L is what? Elongation. So already we know this formula, F is equal to F by A is equal to this, or Young's modulus is equal to F by A by delta L by L. From this, F is equal to minus Y A L into delta L, and just equate it with KY. F is equal to KY, Y is just extension. So here delta L is extension. And from this you are getting K is equal to Y A by L. Just substitute in the formula, T is equal to pi under root M by K, and you are getting T is equal to 2 pi under root ML by Y A. So whenever like this application you are getting, you can use this formula. Okay, note down. Okay, so note down all these things, okay, properly. Let's stop here for today. Bye.